Oscar.
Rotten to see you, too.
With Whoopi Goldberg and Roberta Flack. But there's one mystery.
Oh, yeah!
Telly, where's Julia?
Julia Roberts is missing!
Will she miss the bird calls? The Kraft Corner? The Alphabet Blues?
I can't believe we're lost. I'm going to miss the show.
Don't you miss it right now.
I'm Kathy Richards from Rosedale, Queens, New York, and this is the Rosie O'Donnell Show. On today's show, we have Julia Roberts, Whoopi Goldberg, and Roberta Flack. Hit it, John!
Watch out! Here comes Rosie. Now it's time for the show. She's here and there and everywhere. With some folks you want to know.
It's me, Zoe, Zoe.
There's crafts and laughs.
It's Cool-a-rama.
We got kids and stuff to do.
Hello, everybody. This is your old pal, Grover.
Family fun and tips for mamas.
Great big stars. And maybe you.
Hello there, this Cookie Monster.
Put on your brakes, sit down, get cozy.
And hang out with Rosie.
Ready on your mark, get set, let's go. It's the Rosie O'Donnell Show.
I'm good. Where are you from?
I'm from Rosedale, Queens, New York.
Really? What do you do for a living?
Right now I'm retired from the phone company, but I have a little side thing going on.
Oh, yeah. What's your side thing?
I work as a secretary at a hospital in Far Rockaway, New York.
No kidding?
Yes.
Well, that's great.
Yes.
Listen, everybody, I got some news for you. I'm sorry to tell you, but we're not doing the show here today. I'm going to Sesame Street.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Sesame Street.
Okay.
And you guys can watch it on TV, but thanks for coming.
Okay.
Hope you had a good time.
Bye.
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 See ya.
Whoop, whoop, bow, wow, Barkley.
She should be here by now.
Telly, it's not even time yet.
Yeah, yeah, don't worry, Telly. She'll be here. She promised Elmo.
No, but what if she forgot? Or what if she changed her mind? What if she got bubblegum on the bottom of her shoe and she's stuck to the sidewalk someplace?
Telly, look who's walking down Sesame Street.
She's here!
I'll get bird.
Hey, you guys.
Spread the word.
Yeah.
And everybody welcome Rosie.
I'm here to do my program.
Been counting hours till you got here.
Now scram.
We love Rosie.
And I brought my desk. Great guests.
You're really here. Wow.
Our street is yours now.
Hi, folks.
Need jokes. I got a million.
Maybe a billion.
Hey, Ro, I'll direct the show.
Have to get back to you on that, Prairie Dawn.
And we can share toys.
Aw,
make noise.
How about some fresh toast?
Can I be co-host?
Yes.
We're so excited.
What? We're on TV? Don't panic.
You're all invited.
Snow.
you. Welcome.
You look very pretty today.
You're beautiful.
Oh, thank you, Alice.
Aww.
Are you guys going to be able to stay for the whole show?
Well, we'll be around someplace.
Yeah, me too.
She takes a lot of looking after, this one.
All righty. Well, you guys say hi to John McDee and the McDLTs, and we'll see you later.
Hey, Ro. How are you?
Can you believe we are here
on
Sesame Street?
I kind of can. It's so cool. It's so fun.
Isn't it unbelievable?
It's really wonderful.
What a great street it is.
Great to be here.
All my friends just popping up. Who do you have in the band there?
I know. We have a couple of folks sitting in.
Who do you got?
Who do we have? We have Honker and... and Dinger.
Honker and Dinger! Oh, my goodness.
Gotta love those guys.
Isn't that... I'm so happy that you invited us to come here with my whole show, nonetheless.
We are so glad all of you are here.
Yeah, we're going to have a fun day today.
Hey, Omar.
Yeah, you know who's here today?
Yeah.
Your friend and mine. Whoopi!
Yes.
And we got our buddy Julia Roberts here. Yeah. A new friend. I don't think you've met her yet, but she's a real good friend.
Who is that?
Roberta Flack.
Miss Roberta Flack! Wow!
Can you believe it?
You brought so many friends here.
And you got a new friend.
Yes, that's why Emma wanted you to come too. Yeah, this is Emma's friend, Dorothy.
Hello, Dorothy.
And you see, she loves your show so much, she keeps it on all the time.
She's watching my show there?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, you know, she never gotten to swim on television before.
No, now she's going to be famous.
Yeah, Emma hopes so.
Yeah. I hope she enjoys the show here. We got all our buttons of all our songs.
Look, Rosie. That's Emma's button.
Yeah.
Not the belly button, that's another button.
What is that? What is that button, Duel?
Listen. This is the song, la 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 la, Elmo's song.
Oh!
La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's song.
Oh, that's good. That's I have my own. I have my own buttons too.
Yeah, what you gonna do?
Look what I got here.
La 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 la.
Sesame Street.
Rosie, Elmo, thank you so much for coming.
Are all your friends here? Is Rosita around?
Yeah. Rosita!
I am right here in the window.
Oh, hi, Rosita!
Hello!
How are you?
I'm excellent. I am so extremely, unbelievably happy to be here.
Really? Yeah, I'm happy to see you. Look great in person.
Oh, thank you very much.
Yeah,
Rosie,
welcome.
I have a little news for you.
You got news?
Yes.
What?
Julia Roberts is not here yet. But you don't. Do not panic. Do not panic because, you know, I can pretend to be Julia Roberts if you want.
No. You don't have to pretend. I'm sure she'll be here, Rosita.
Yeah, but you know what? A lot of people say that we look alike.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they say that we have the same smile. Look.
Yeah, I can see the resemblance now that you pointed it out.
Yeah.
But you just let me know when she's here. I'm sure she'll be here any minute.
Yeah. All right.
Don't you think? Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
I think so, too.
Yeah. All right.
Also, we're going to do a little craft corner today with some kids on stuff you can do on a rainy day.
Oh,
your friend
fun.
Ruthie's going to be here to help me with that.
Ruthie.
Isn't that great?
Yeah.
And Big Bird and I are going to do some kids with, talk to kids who can do bird calls.
Oh, that sounds like fun.
Can you do a fish call?
Yeah. Bloop, 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 bloop.
You know who's our producer today?
Who?
Your friend and mine. Telly!
Telly!
Hi, Telly!
Hi, Telly!
Thank you. Thank you for having confidence in me, Rosie. And I don't want you to worry. I'm sure that Julia Roberts is just stuck in traffic.
Yeah.
Unless, of course, an elephant fell in her limousine and they can't get the elephant off. Oh, no. Oh, no, an elephant on a limousine. Somebody get the jaws of life. Hurry!
Kelly! Telly, I'm sure she's fine. Yeah. I'm sure she'll be here any minute.
So
just calm down, Telly, okay?
Okay. Yeah.
All right. Jeez, I hope she shows up soon. Hey, we'll be right back with Whoopi! Don't go away.
Oh,
you guys,
hey. Oh,
up.
Home, James.
Rosie said you guys could get me to Sesame Street in no time at all.
What? Shortcut!
Oh, good.
That way! Whoa! No. That way! Whoa!
Okay, let's just hold on a second. Mm-hmm. I don't care which way we go, as long as we get there.
Okay. That way! Whoa!
That might be a good
That's a good one. Oh, welcome to our little show.
Right. And don't forget to take a deep breath.
Take a breath.
Yeah, just be yourself.
Be myself.
Know.
Wow.
And you might straighten your collar.
My collar? Is
yeah,
it
just,
a little,
just a little bit. I feel very pretty, though.
Jeez.
Yeah.
You know, Prairie Dawn, I'm so surprised you know so much about this, doing a show.
Oh, well, you know, I have put on hundreds and hundreds of pageants on Sesame Street.
Oh, sure, you have, yeah.
You've seen them, right?
Oh, of course. I've been here before on Sesame
food
Street.
The food seasons, all sorts of, and I make all the costumes.
Yeah, fabulous. You're very talented.
Well, thank you. I do the lighting.
But you know what? I'm really surprised, Prairie Dawn.
What?
You know, here we are on TV, and you're not even nervous.
We're what?
We're on TV.
We're now?
Yeah, right now. We're on TV.
Millions of people?
Yeah, millions of people.
Hair, makeup.
Well, Prairie, just go to my dressing room. Should just wait in my dressing room, I guess. Yeah, okay. Well, I guess I'll do this interview without Prairie Dawn. I'm so glad our first guest could join us on this very special day. She's truly one of the biggest stars around. Do me a favor and say hi to Academy Award winner, Whoopi Goldberg!
Hi, Rosie.
How are you?
I'm really glad to be here. I'm fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sesame Street, have you been on this street before?
Oh, I've been on this street before.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I remember
I
had the best time. I was here with Elmo.
Really?
Yeah, you know, we'd go back for a ways.
Yeah.
And we'd had a good talk that day.
Hmm, I wonder what happened.
Elmo thinks Whoopi's skin is a very pretty brown.
Oh, well, thank you, Elmo. Hey, you know what?
Huh?
I like your fur, too.
Really?
Yeah. It's a great color. Red.
Yeah.
And it's nice and bright and soft, too. It's nice and furry.
Yeah, Elmo's fur is furry, all right. But it's not like Whoopi's skin.
Mm-mm. Well, that's only because fur and skin are different.
Wow.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah.
You always have fun when you come to this street, don't you?
I love coming to this street.
Your grandkids ever come here to Sesame Street?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah.
I hope the new one comes.
You got a new grandkid?
I got a new grandson.
How old?
He's going to be a month on Monday.
Well, congratulations to you, Grandma.
Yeah, thank you.
Do you feel like a grandma?
No, I don't feel like a grandma. I'm not sure what's happening, but I keep thinking that something is supposed to, like, ground me.
Yeah.
And I'm supposed to become adult and think about adult stuff. And all I can think about is running around with them.
Right.
Just poking them in place and going, look, okay. But so far, they won't let me take them for long.
Are you the kind of grandma who, like, gets involved and starts, like, telling your daughter how to do it, how to raise
No. She's taller than me.
Oh.
Yeah.
They have
once they get to be a certain height, you have to let them do it. No, but I ask a lot of questions because it's been a while for me. You know, it's been 25 years since I've had to deal with a little baby.
Right.
So I was there when he came out looking a bit like a mud man.
Really?
Yeah, it was all muddy. And just, he started to like say something like, what the, hey? And big smile, and it was pretty cool.
So he's a happy fella.
He seems to be a happy fella.
Well, good. I'm glad for you and
yeah,
for your daughter.
Too. Yeah, me too.
Now, do they get to come and watch you on Hollywood Squares when you're filming
they
that?
They come and they run amok.
They do.
Yes, and it's great for the mom because my daughter can just go, okay, see ya.
Somebody else watch
them. That's
for
right.
An hour.
That's right. And her husband goes, are they gone?
Yeah.
So they disappear for lunch and stuff. So it's
I had
great.
A great time doing that show. I got to tell you.
I love you when you come and play. I love you anyway, but I love when you come and play because it's always a good energy. But just between us,
yeah.
Because we're on Sesame Street, we have to tell the truth.
Right.
You don't bluff much.
No.
Because
I don't.
You don't.
You're supposed to bluff, aren't you?
A little. Just a nudge.
Yeah. You know, if I know the answer, I say it very firmly, and I look right at the person, and I go, "This is the truth," and I make them believe it. If I don't know it, I go like this. lima beans. Because I feel guilty if I lie to them.
Well, yes, yes. I'm learning not to.
They don't give you the answer.
No, because it's against the law.
It is.
For us to get the answer.
You think
so,
it's against the law for me to go, I don't know what it is?
I tell you, when the police called me about it, I didn't tell them that I knew you personally. No, I think it's great because people come to trust you.
Yeah.
But what happens when you don't know the answer?
I say, I have no clue and please do not believe me. But one
but what if you're right?
Well, that did happen.
See?
Do you know what happened once? Caroline Ray from Sabrina, the Teenage Witch.
Yes.
She kept bothering me at the commercial break, saying to me, "You are cheating. You are not playing fairly. You have to bluff." So the next person came, I bluffed, and the guilt I still carry to this day for that man named Steve, who I bluffed, and I made him lose the game with me.
But he went on to get a car, Rosie.
Yes, he did.
He won a car
and
at the end. Okay. You gave him a car.
The little things that make me happy.
Little things.
I know you're a big fan of TV. I heard you telling me at Hollywood Squares, your new show, Forgive and Forget. You enjoy watching
it. I watched this show. I have to tell you, it's insane.
It is a little
Have
nutty.
You seen this
have
show?
Have you seen this show, Forgive and Forget?
This one, wait, there was a lady, she came on, she wanted her mother to come to her wedding. This tells you I don't have enough to do in my life.
Right.
Her mother, when she wants the mother to come, the mother is really mad at her. The mother has not spoken to her. She comes to the lady who runs the show, she goes, "I want my mother. I got that in my wedding." And the lady says, "Well, look now, you know, maybe she'll be behind the door. I wanted to come. I wanted to come to the wedding." So she says, "Well, let's go see if your mother's there. And if she's there, it means she's forgiving you. She's going to come to the wedding." And so the lady walks over, and she takes the door, and she whips it open, and there's nobody there. She went like this. I got hysterical in my house. I felt terrible, you know, because she wanted her mother to be there. But you kind of understood that she knew if she was there, she was going to be greeted by... And then the lady sat down. She was, you know, comforting the lady. And then they showed a tape of her mother. And her mother said... "You know, I love you, but I'm not coming to that wedding. I wanted to be back there behind the door, but I couldn't do it. Couldn't do it. But remember, I love you." I got crazy. It was insane. Insane.
Too much. You know, are you good at your ABCs? What?
I'm better than I was.
Yeah. It's not easy to learn, is it?
No, it's not. It's very hard to learn the ABCs.
Well, my friend Baby Bear, you know him.
Yes.
Yeah, he's still trying to learn his ABCs. He's not having a lot of success. He wanted to come and talk to you about that after the break.
That would be great.
All right, let's do that.
Okay.
Let's see how... You think Prairie Dawn's okay?
I'm not sure about Prairie Dawn.
Yeah.
She looked a little flustered.
I think she's probably just relaxing in my dressing room.
Oh, I can handle this. After all, I've put on hundreds of pageants. I've been anchor of fairy tales today. This is no problem. It's easy. I can do it. You can do it. I believe in you. Yes. Ow. Hey, who did that? Who did that?
Do it.
Stop that.
You're
I'm trying to concentrate
pretty.
Here.
Yeah.
I'm trying to concentrate.
Pretty.
People.
Oh, yeah.
People.
Oh, yeah.
God.
Pretty.
Oh, for goodness sake.
I comb your hair.
How am I ever going to have a moment of silence here?
Can I comb your hair?
People.
You look so pretty.
People.
We'll be right back with Baby Bear.
Rosie will be back in just a... What do you mean I'm facing the wrong? Oh, I am so embarrassed.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S. Cookie Monster isn't a letter of the alphabet. It goes Q, R, S, D, U, V. You're just teasing me.
See what I'm saying?
What do you mean, baby?
What I'm saying is everybody knows the alphabet, but I mean, even those guys. Everyone knows the alphabet. I don't know it yet.
Well, you know, it's hard to learn, baby
bear. There's like hundreds of letters.
Yeah.
You gotta follow the strict order.
Yeah.
Proud.
Whoop, it wasn't easy for you to learn, was it?
No, it wasn't. You know, you just gotta keep practicing and practicing. It takes time to learn
things. I know, but sometimes I get depressed, you know? I get the blues.
You get the blues?
I get the alphabet blues.
Oh, my goodness.
And I like to sing about it. You know, we want to help me sing a song about it?
You know, you need your blues glasses on there, baby bear.
Of course, you gotta have the glasses to sing the blues.
All right, that's good.
Yeah.
Let's get our glasses on, Whoop.
All right.
How's that?
That looks pretty cool.
All right, baby bear. We'll do it with you. All right.
Feeling hopeful.
Uh-huh.
I go A, B, C, D, E, F.
Uh-huh.
That's as far as I go, and it hurts me to know there's a whole lot of alphabet left.
Aww.
But why as I do with all of my might?
All your might.
To think of the letters and line them up white.
Yeah. What happens?
I can't do it.
Oh, no.
Can't get through it.
Oh, no.
You know what? I got those alphabet blues.
I understand. Sometimes I'm really rolling, going G-H-I-J-K-L-M. Then I just lose my way, and there's more letters to say, but I can't seem to come up with them. But try as I do with all of my might, I try to think of the letters and line them up right.
It's hard.
I can't do it.
I
can't get through it.
Sing it, Rosie.
You know what I got?
What you got?
The alphabet blue.
It's contagious.
The saddest feeling I ever get is to get all the way to V.
Yeah.
The only four letters left and all are bereft because they just don't know what they can be, you know?
Try
as I do
with
all of our might.
All of our might.
To think of those letters and line them up right.
We can do it. We'll get through it. You know, someday we'll say the alphabet from A to Z. We won't forget.
See?
Totally right.
You hear me?
I hear you.
You hear what I'm saying?
I hear what you're saying. Hey, Whoop, what's coming up next here on this show?
Well, I think next, Big Bird and Kit Bird callers.
Exactly. Whoopi Goldberg and Baby Bear. Yeah. We'll be right back with Big Bird after this.
We're running kind of late here.
What? No,
we are. And I think maybe I should just go ahead and do my hair and makeup so that I'm all ready when we get to Sesame Street.
Makeup!
After 19
comes 20.
20, right.
Wow. Where am I? This is the actual nest where our next guest lives on Sesame Street. I can't wait to see him, so please help me welcome everyone's favorite six-year-old, the one and only, Big Bird! Hi, Big Bird! Hi, Big Bird! How are you?
Oh, great.
So great to see you.
Oh, thank you. Oh, Rosie, that's my nest.
Yeah, that's your nest.
Oscar's going to be very upset.
How come?
Well, that's where his trash can usually is.
Yeah, we moved his trash can just for the time we're on this show.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Usually he calls me an overgrown bag of giblets.
I know.
He's not mad at me now.
That's because he's grouchy.
Hey, what am I going to do on this show? First, maybe I could sing. La, la, la.
Yeah.
Or Rosie, I could do this.
What are you doing? Wow, that's a good trick.
Or I can sing and do this.
Wow, Big Bird.
What do you want?
I don't even think that I can do that.
Oh.
No.
Really?
Well, Big Bird, we know how much that you love birds and you love kids.
Well, I know all about being one.
Yeah, of course. So we thought we would get some kids who love birds and have them come out and do little bird impressions for you.
Oh, I love that.
Is that a good idea?
Yes.
All right, please welcome bird callers 10-year-old Shira and 9-year-old Amber. Come on over. Hi, Shira. Hi, Amber. Did you meet Big Bird?
Hello.
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 Nice to meet you, Amber.
Now, how old are you, sweetie?
I'm 10.
You're 10 years old, and you?
I'm 9.
9, and you're both kind of bird experts?
Sorta, you might say that.
Yeah, you really enjoy birds.
Yeah.
What's the bird that you have here on your neck?
Oh, this is the black brant. It lives in northern Canada, Alaska, and Russia, and during the winter, it flies down to Mexico to get eelgrass, which is its main source of food.
Are you kidding me? How did you learn all of that? Scooch over here.
Well, sometimes I watch the birds.
Yeah?
And they're very interesting to watch.
Where do you see one? Up in Canada?
Actually, I have never actually seen this bird.
Yeah.
But
you got a nice picture.
But I like it.
Yeah. Now, you can do a bird call of that specific
yes,
bird?
Yes, actually, I can.
Actually, let me hear it.
Ha! Ha! Ha!
You know?
That was really good!
You know what it
really
sounds like?
Really, really good! What does it sound like, Big Bird?
That sounds like my Uncle Charlie on a Saturday night.
Your Uncle Charlie.
I also know some other calls.
What other calls do you know?
I know the canary.
Let's hear a canary. Woo!
Wow.
Woo! Woo!
I also know the seagull.
You know a seagull? Give me a seagull. Well, that's pretty good, honey.
I can also do the pigeon.
You also know the pigeon?
Yeah.
Let me hear.
Ooh. Ooh. Ooh.
Wow, isn't that pretty
good?
Sounds like Bernice. That's Bert's pigeon,
yeah.
Right? Yeah. All right, sweetie girl, you got one too, Amber?
Yes.
What do you got on your card there?
I got the tufted titmouse.
The tufted titmouse. I have some of those at the back of my house because I have bird feeders. They're very common here in New York, aren't they?
I don't know.
I think they are. But can you do a bird call from that bird?
Yeah, do it, do it.
Okay.
Sounds like the beginning of that TV show, Mayberry R.F. Andy Griffin.
Sounds something like Peter, Peter, Peter.
Peter, Peter,
yeah.
Peter. Can you do another one?
I can also do the black vulture.
Black vulture, go ahead. Let's hear that one.
It sounds kind of like a prehistoric dinosaur.
It sounds like a prehistoric dinosaur. Go ahead, honey, let's hear it.
Wow, let's try that. Let's try
it. Want to try that? All right, Big Bird. Wow, Shira and Amber, those are pretty cool.
You're good.
Yeah, we got you a little something.
Yes.
A little thank you.
Right here in my nest.
Here in the nest is a surprise for you guys. We got you some bird watching binoculars and some bird stuff and bird feeders and a bird book. One for you and one for you, Amber, too. Let me grab this one. And you guys get to go to Busch Gardens.
Hi.
In Tampa, Florida. From all over the world. Isn't that fun?
Yeah.
Thank you very much for being here on the show on Sesame Street. Hey, Big Bird.
Yeah.
We're going to come back with crafts after this. But first, we're going to check in with Telly and see what's going on with Julia Roberts.
Oh, yeah. Good idea.
Telly, what's going on with Julia?
Julia Roberts will be here any minute. Unless, of course, she slipped on a banana peel. Oh, no. Maybe she slipped on two banana peels. Oh, why must people lit her?
It's gonna be okay, Telly. It's gonna be okay, really. Calm down and breathe. We'll be right back with the Craft Corner. He worries, doesn't he? He worries.
Pretty woman, love me dog and me. Pretty woman, whatever.
You know what? You know what? I think that we should call Rosie and let her know that we're running late.
Hey, Rosie!
Rosie!
Oh, hello!
No. I mean on the telephone.
On the telephone!
On the telephone!
Me call!
No, me call!
No, I call! No!
Oh, sorry.
Oh, great. Oh, what are we gonna do now?
Rosie! Hello!
Rosie!
We couldn't come to Sesame Street without bringing my favorite Craft Corner. Helping me craft is one of my funniest friends from Sesame Street, Ruthie. Hi, Ruthie.
Hi, Rosie.
And one of my grouchiest friends, Oscar the Grouch.
Hello.
Oh, Oscar. Nice to see you, Oscar.
Yeah, well, rotten to see you, too.
All right. And 8-year-old cutie patootie, Amanda Hickey. Hi, Amanda.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. Rosie?
Yeah?
Here is a fun project for kids to do.
Okay.
We have a recipe here that will make beautiful clay. I mean, look, you see, isn't that beautiful?
It is beautiful,
beautiful
clay.
Beautiful clay from stale bread and messy glue.
Hey, wait a minute.
I'm sure that means you're excited, right? Hearing the word
you're
messy.
You're going to make something out of stale bread?
That's right.
And messy glue?
Yeah.
That's right.
A yucky show the whole Grouch family can watch together at last.
Exactly.
And Rosie, it rates one glue gun on a difficulty of 1 to 5.
Which means it's easy. Anybody can
easy.
Do this one
Simple.
At home. So here's what you have to do. You got to get some stale bread,
stale
right, Amanda?
Bread. Coming up.
And you break it up into little tiny pieces.
Chunk
For
it
each
off.
Piece of bread you use, you have to use 1 tablespoon of Elmer's glue, right there. In this bowl, we have 5 slices right of stale bread, so we have 5 tablespoons of glue. You put the glue in, right Ooh. There.
That is gooey, messy.
Nice and messy, yeah. gooey. And you stir yeah. it all up together. We suggest you use rubber gloves because it gets very messy. Also,
yeah.
1 tablespoon of water.
Aqua.
Put that in as well.
Aqua.
You mush, you mush, you mush, you mush, you mush.
Oh, this is fun.
Isn't this good?
Nice
gooey.
And gooey.
Yeah. Add a little food coloring that you can get in your local department grocery store. Little this food coloring in there.
Food
you keep mushing.
Yum.
And Whoa. Eventually, you know what you come out with?
I
mush.
Get it in.
Mush. What can you get in, sweetie? Oh, let me open the top.
You got to open the top of the thing to get
Look,
the color in.
You open the top and you get the food coloring in there. You mush it up enough and you end up with
mush.
This. Ta-da! It ends up, believe it or not.
It's a goo.
You have to knead it until it's no longer sticky. It'll take you about
10 minutes.
Yeah. Now let me get these off for you, sweetheart, so that you can decorate with us. Okay?
Woo, this is great.
Then you have something sort of similar to Play-Doh or molding clay that you would buy at a store, only it's very cheap and you can do it at home.
Look at all the things you can make.
What did you make, Ruthie?
Well, I made this little clown. Isn't that cute?
Look at that, Ruthie, you're so artistic.
Yeah. And Rosie, I made the hair by putting it in here. I'll
Which is
you.
A garlic press.
Yeah, a garlic press.
You take a little garlic press that you have in your kitchen.
I like that.
You put a little of the clay in,
put it
like
in
Ruthie's
there.
Doing right now.
Right
and
there.
You smush and look, squiggly hair right there for your clown or for something that you're making. I made a little slice of pizza right here, pretend pizza, and a rose for Rosie. See that, Amanda? Isn't that cute?
Look at this, spaghetti and meatballs.
Isn't that great?
Yeah.
An octopus, or you know what you could do? You could take a cookie roll or a dough roller and roll it flat out in a pan, take a cookie cutter, and you come out with a little horse.
Isn't that cute?
Oh, isn't that cute?
Isn't it cute?
Well, this is supposed to be grouchy. You're making cute little animals and stuff.
Rosie, look what I'm doing.
What a total misuse of good trash.
Oscar, would you just be quiet and watch? I'm making this for you, Oscar, to wear. It's beads.
Yes, you make little tiny balls and you put it through the string. You let it dry overnight, and then when you're done, you put clear nail polish on it in the morning, and it'll stay like that forever, and you can make yourself a little necklace. Isn't that delicious?
Sure, you can wear this to any formal occasion and look just gorgeous.
Yes, you can.
Gorgeous.
And if you want information on how to do that, the Craft Newsletter, you send a self-addressed stamped envelope to Rosie's Craft Corner, Newsletter PO Box 5298, New York, New York, 10185, or on America Online, keyword Rosie. Now, Amanda here, cutie patootie, you made me something special. What did you make?
I made candle holders. You get a jar, and you get nail polish, and you paint it with the nail polish, and then you put a candle in it, and then it comes a candle holder.
Isn't that nice? An old jar of baby food, because you have a little baby brother.
Aww.
That's right. And this very adorable jumping frog that she made. Amanda cut out a piece of felt, the shape of a frog. She connected it to a clothespin, and tell us what happens. Look at this. The frog hops!
Look what I made.
What'd you make, Oscar?
A rotten cookie.
A rotten cookie! Everything dirty or dingy or dusty. Look at a nice necklace for you, Oscar.
It's too attractive.
It really is.
Oh, boy.
Hey, Amanda, did you see Julia Roberts anywhere?
Yes.
You did?
I think in the hedge.
In the hedge outside?
No, the hair.
In the hair?
The hair place.
In the hair place? Well, let's go look there. Telly, any news from Julia? Is she in a hair place? Where is she?
I don't know. She is missing. Julia Roberts is missing. If anyone out there knows where she is, please, can you tell her how to get to Sesame Street? Please, please, I'm begging you, please.
Oh, Telly. Coming up next, our favorite songs with Roberta Flack.
Oh.
Sesame Street Sing Along.
Rosie will be right back after this important cookie.
Well, hi, everybody. We're back. Elmo, who's here with you?
Ladies and gentlemen, Elmo's new good friend, Miss Roberta
Flack! Hi, Roberta.
Hi, Rosie. How are you?
I'm really good. How are you?
I came because I wanted to sing with these guys. Can we sing some songs?
You want to sing?
Yeah, I want to sing.
Listen, Elmo has a lot of other friends that would like to meet you, too.
Okay, let's do
friends,
that.
Friends, come on. Meet Miss Roberta Flack.
And so are we gonna sing though? I'm really singing.
What you
wanna sing
so bad?
What song? What do you think this?
Let's sing them all.
Yeah.
Sunny day, sweeping the clouds away. On my way to where the to Sesame Street.
How to get to Sesame Street. How to get to Sesame Street.
Well, the donkey, you're the one. You make bad time lots of fun. Rubber ducky, I'm awfully fond of you.
Oh, every day when I make my way to the tubby,
always brings the mail.
The rain or snow or sleet or hail.
He'll work and work the whole day through.
It's true. To get your letter safe to you. Oh, the postman is a person in your neighborhood. In your neighborhood. In your neighborhood. The postman is a person in your neighborhood. He's a person that you meet when you're walking down the street.
Again.
believe we're lost. I'm gonna miss the show.
I really
wanted to be there.
Gosh, we have had such a fun time here on Sesame Street.
Yeah.
It was great.
Yeah, I loved it.
Let's do it again.
It's so sad that Julia didn't show up.
Yeah, Telly, where's Julia?
It's over, Rosie. It's over. Julia's not coming. Oh, now the show is ruined. It's a flop. It's a disaster. It's a washout 11. A real turkey. Ah, I knew this would happen. I knew it.
Okay, Telly. It's all right, Telly. It's okay. I'm sure she's fine. Julia, wherever you are, we love you. Yeah. Goodbye, everybody.
Bye.
We'll see you guys.
Bye.
I've got an idea. Why didn't I think of this before? We'll ask someone directions, okay? Stop the car, please.
Stop!
Enough with the stopping. Oh, miss?
Hey, lady!
Nice. Miss?
Rosie!
Julia!
We've been driving all over town looking for you.
We've been waiting for you. The whole show's over.
Over?
It's over.
What are we gonna do now?
Lunch! Great, come on! Move over! Who are you?
American Eagle serving over 260 destinations in 45 countries worldwide. American Airlines, something special in the air.
While in New York, guests of the Rosie O'Donnell Show stay at the stylish Four Diamond La Parca Meridian Hotel on West 57th Street in the heart of Midtown Manhattan.